Hi everyone, welcome to a session on Power Automate Licensing Enforcement. My name is Amreek Singh, I'm a Senior Solution Architect for the Fast Track Team for Dynamics. We will start the session with understanding the enforcement, followed by enforcement process, scenarios, and timelines. Then we'll look at how to identify non-compliant flows, then the remediation of those flows, and we're going to end the session with some resources, including some of the PowerShell scripts I'm going to use in this demo. Understanding the enforcement. So what is this enforcement about? It's not about throttling or billable actions. It's about premium Power Automate flows. It's about assigning proper licenses to your premium PA flows. A premium Power Automate flow is a flow that uses premium connectors. Dataverse, Azure Data Lake, and Azure DevOps are some of the examples of premium connectors. Let's compare the connectors' use rights included in different plans. We can divide the PA licenses into two categories, standalone plans and seeded plans. Standalone plans include Power Automate Premium, Power Automate Process, Legacy Power Automate Per User, and Per Flow plans. With standalone plans, you have access to both standard and premium connectors. Let's look at the seeded plans now. With Office 365, you have access to only standard connectors. But if you compare the Power Apps Premium and Dynamics 365 plans, you have access to standard connectors, but you also have access to premium connectors only if the flow is in-app context. What do we mean by in-app context? A Power Automate flow is within the app context if it is using the same data sources for triggers or actions as your Dynamics 365 application. On top of it, the flow and the app should be in the same environment, and the flow should be interacting with the entities used in your app. Let's look at the example. Your organization has connected Azure DevOps with your Dynamics 365 application. Just say, in this example, if you change the status of the case to escalated in your app and it triggers a flow that creates a work item in Azure DevOps, then this flow is within the app context. The same definition applies to Power Apps. The only difference is the Canvas app can have different data sources, such as SQL database, SharePoint, or even Dataverse. In the second example, a Power App is interacting or using SQL database as a data source. If you create a flow, the flow will be in the app context if it is reading or writing the data to SQL database or using a built-in Power App triggers or actions. For example, send a push notification to the app. Enforcement process, scenarios, and timelines. This is the enforcement process for most of the impacting scenarios, except a few exceptions. We will talk about the exceptions in the next slide. When we initiate a new enforcement, we send a notification to admins in the Power Platform Admin Center. If no action is taken for 30 days, we send an email notification to owner and co-owners. We display an in-product banner in the Power Automate portal. We send an email notification to admins, and new flows with the premium features will be turned off by default. Again, if no action is taken for 90 days, non-compliant flows will be turned off. We will send an email notification to owner and co-owners. At any stage of the process, admins or owners can assign the premium licenses or associate these flows with corresponding apps. Let's look at impacting scenarios and timelines. These timelines include initial admin notifications to the actual enforcement dates. We are deploying this enforcement a geo-region at a time, so these dates may vary based on your location. Let's look at the scenarios. Premium flows where flow owner left the organization. Premium flows where the flow owner doesn't have a premium license. Premium flows owned by a user with Power App license, but the flows are not within app context. Premium flows owned by a user with Dynamics 365 license, but the flows are not within app context. Premium flows owned by a service principal without a per flow or a process license, and the flows are not within app context. The last one is interesting. It's not in a public documentation yet, but we are thinking about this. This is a scenario where customers have over-allocated per flow licenses. For example, you may have purchased 5 per flow licenses, but you ended up allocating them to 10 different flows. Identify non-compliance flows. You can get a list of non-compliant flows in PPAC. If you click on licenses, then select the environments. Select your environment. And from the drop-down, select Power Automate as a product. Then you can get a list of non-compliant flows. You also have an option to download this report. You can also retrieve the list of non-compliant flows using PowerShell. is a much better way, as you can automate this, or you can retrieve the list for all the different auths in a tenant. Let's see this in action. I'm using PowerShell IIC for this demo. The first step is to install PowerApps, PowerShell modules. Once you finish with this step, you can run this command, get admin flow at risk of suspension. It takes two parameters. The first one is environment name. Here you're passing environment ID. You can get this from the PPAC. The second parameter is API version. This is hard-coded here. If you run this command, it should display the list of non-compliant flows for this specific org. As you can see, the list is appearing. It will return the flow name, if the flow is enabled or not, display name, created time, and some other information here. If you want to push this information into a CSV file, you can do that by using this command. Let's have a look at this new script. We added that 2 or 3 weeks ago. What it will do is it will give you a list of non-compliant flows for the first 500 orgs in the tenant. So you don't have to go through one environment at a time. So you can also modify this, this script to push this information into a CSV file if you want to. Let's look at another variation of this. Here is another script. It will do exactly like the last one, but it will create a separate file for every environment in the tenant. Let's run this command. It takes a bit of time to generate these files. So some organization, they don't want to run this command for their default org. Maybe they have a lot of flows and stuff. They don't want the command to time out. So what you can do is you can write a little bit of code and compare the environment name with your default org. You can skip that. Let's have a look at the folder. Refresh this one. So you see the new files are appearing. That's the name of the environment. This is a default org. That's another environment. If I refresh it, it should have, yeah, Center of Excellence is there. Booking demo is there. Remediation. Now we have a list of non-compliant flows. What are our options? For cloud flows which are using premium connectors under Power App or Dynamics 365 license, you can assign a Power Automate Premium or Power Automate Per User license to the owner, allocate a process or a workflow license to the environment, and assign it to the flow, enable page billing on the environment, or associate your flow to a Power App or Dynamics 365 app. You have two options. You can use PowerShell commands, or you can use UX in the maker experience. For the over-allocation of workflow licenses, you can allocate a process or a workflow license to the environment and assign it to the flow, or change flows with the lower billable actions to Power Automate Premium or Power User Plan. To associate a flow to an app, go to the Maker's Experience, look for associated apps, then click on Edit. It will display a list of available apps. Select an app and then press Save. This will associate your flow to that app. You can also use this PowerShell command to associate your flow to an app. This command takes three parameters: environment name, flow name, and app name. Environment name is again the app ID. You can find this in a PPAC. The flow name is already there in the suspension list. App name, if it's a model-driven app, then you can find the name in the solution. If it's a Canvas app, you can click on details and it should be an app ID, so good. In this case scenario, I didn't provide the proper app name, so this command should fail. When I run this command, so it fails, specified app name does not exist. If I change the app name to a proper app name, then it should succeed with status code 200. I have written another script. Just say you have hundreds of orgs in your tenant. You may have 30, 40 flows you have to associate to different apps. So instead of running this command one at a time, what you can do is you can go to the suspension list file and you can add another column at the end called app name, and you can provide the name of the app, you know. So in this case scenario, the command will read the app name, the flow name, and the environment name from the CSV file. So if we go back, so this script will read the CSV file and will run the command for every single record in the CSV file. So you don't have to run this command one at a time. So you can just execute as a file. And now there's another one here. Remove admin flow part app context. If you have to remove the association for whatever reason, you can run this command. So if I run this command, so it will return me the code 204. So it will remove the association between the flow and the app. The resources. Here are some useful resources. This one is one of the most important one. It has all the latest and greatest information about licensing, enforcement, process, and the timelines, PowerShell commandlets. It is a link to all the PowerShell commands related to Power Platform. The third one is the link to the PowerShell scripts I use in this demo. I have uploaded these files to GitHub. Thank you for listening. I hope you found this session useful.